Photography has come a long way in its relatively short history. In almost 200 years, the camera developed from a plain box that took blurry photos to the high-tech mini computers found in today's DSLRs and smartphones. The basic concept of photography has been around since about the 5th century BCE. It wasn't until an Iraqi scientist developed something called the camera obscura in the 11th century. The camera obscura did not actually record images. If you poke a hole in the wall of a darkroom, you create camera obscura. Light passing through the hole is projected upside down, though they could be traced to create accurate drawings of real objects such as buildings. In 1724, Johann Heinrich Schultz discovers the substances which mix with silver nitrate react to light and creates images. Sadly, the images fade soon. Photography, as we know it today, began in 1826 in France. Joseph Nicéphore-Niépce used a portable camera obscura to expose a pewter plate coated with bitumen to light. This process takes 8 hours or even several days to expose, but this is the first recorded image that did not fade quickly. After his death, Joseph's partner Louis Daguerre continues his working and creates the first practical photographic process in 1833, the daguerreotype. Daguerreotype is the forerunner of modern film. A copper plate was coated with silver and exposed to iodine vapor before it was exposed to light. To create the image on the plate, the early daguerreotypes had to be exposed to light for up to 15 minutes. In 1839, the French government buys and declares the daguerreotype free to the world. Thus the evolution begins, the first photo of a human. Although this exposure lasted around 7 minutes, a man was getting his shoes polished and was standing perfectly still, thus making history. And also the world's first selfie is taken by a guy named Robert Cornelius. In 1840, Henry Fox Talbot unveils the collotype, a process based on negatives, that allows for paper copies to be made. However, Talbot tried to charge license fees for the collotype. So it didn't really catch on, compared to Louis Daguerre. Sir John Herschel, who published many essential research papers, had coined the term photography from the Greek words of light and drawing. Around 1850s, mobile photo studios were arranged, because photos had to be developed on site. Exposure times were about 3 minutes long, so people use neck braces and drugs to keep still. In the year 1861, the world's first color photograph was produced. In 1871, Richard Leach Maddox invented gelatin dry plate silver bromide, which made it possible to take a picture and develop it later. In 1878, the Englishman Edward Muybridge set up 12 cameras with wired triggers to capture the path of galloping horse to create world's first photo sequence. In 1884, George Eastman, of Rochester, New York, developed dry gel on paper, or film, to replace the photographic plate. So that a photographer no longer needed to carry boxes of plates and toxic chemicals around. In July 1888, Eastman's Kodak camera went on the market with the slogan "You press the button, we do the rest." The Kodak came preloaded with 100 exposures, that needed to be sent back to the factory for processing and reloading when the roll was finished. Now anyone could take a photograph and leave the complex parts of the process to others, and photography became available for the mass market. In 1901, with the introduction of the Kodak Brownie, an affordable box camera that introduces the concept of the snapshot, the Leitz company employee, Oscar Barnack, builds the revolutionary 35mm Leica 1, which goes into production in 1925. The camera allows photographers to go mobile and capture some of the most iconic images in history. In late 1940s, 35mm film became cheap enough for the majority of consumers to use. In 1949, single lens reflex SLR camera arrives. In 1957, first digital image is created from a scan. However, digital cameras only arrived little later in 1975. In the late 1970s and early 1980s, compact cameras that were capable of making image control decisions on their own were introduced. These point-and-shoot cameras calculated shutter speed, aperture, and focus, leaving photographers free to concentrate on composition. In 1975, Stephen Sasson invented the first self-contained digital camera at Eastman Kodak. But nobody at Kodak is interested in digital. In 1991, Kodak switched to digital. In the year 2004, the digital revolution begins. Other manufacturers quickly followed and offered different variety of digital SLR cameras. Later, Kodak files for bankruptcy in 2012. In 2000s, the first mobile phone with camera came out. The point-and-shoot photography had been more accessible to large number of people. At present, modern smartphones have insanely powerful cameras.